Do we expect to see any big change in terms of direction there? Is there any issues that we should be flagging in terms of how Japan may be looking out towards those Indo-Pacific region, the geostrategic issues with a new leader, or is it pretty much business as usual in terms of foreign policy?
Well, it's not business as usual because Japan continues to shift. Japan has gone from a country where in which Australia or the United States had to kind of pull them along in terms of the international community, international trade agreements, international security, to a country which in every respect is a leader right now. So there really isn't a big shift between Prime Minister Suga and now Prime Minister Kishida. All of the candidates who really lined up for the prime ministership were similar in their views in terms of the changing security situation in the region, their growing concern about the role of China, and they were quite vocal on that. So, and in that, there was also not a major difference between them and the previous administration. So continuity, but continuity of change. And that is, whether it's on trade, whether it is on the environment, on whether it's on security, Japan is a much more proactive leader in the Indo-Pacific than it has been before.